A major volcanic eruption has just occurred, causing a volcano to literally blow its top, producing such a large volume of erupted materials that now parts of Australia are under a volcanic ash advisory. Yes, Australia, specifically its Northern Territory. This video, taken by a local approximately 22 miles away from the eruption site, shows the Lewotobi Volcano on November 7th, which sent a plume of sustained ash up to an altitude of 55,000 feet, or 16,764 meters. This is 15,000 feet higher than the deadly and widely damaging eruption Lewotobi produced during the night of November 3rd and 4th. But why did this latest eruption occur? Specifically, due to a combination of a thick lava flow rapidly filling its summit crater and the fact that the volcano's magma conduit was being supplied more magma than it could erupt. This latter factor was especially important, causing a plug to form in the magma conduit. What followed was a rapid buildup of gas and pressure until it inevitably reached a level where it could break through overlying rock, generating a major eruption. However, luckily, this buildup of pressure not only occurred during the daytime when it is easiest to evacuate people, but it was also detected by scientists, causing new evacuations and Lewotobi's exclusion zone to be expanded from 7 to 8 kilometers in specific sectors. Then, at 10:40 a.m., the plug broke and large amounts of gas and pressure were rapidly released. The heavier bits of the eruption plume quickly fell back to the ground in multiple sectors around the volcano, generating pyroclastic flows that advanced at high speeds, incinerating what I preliminarily estimate to be 18.14 square kilometers of forest. These pyroclastic flows nearly reached a settlement to the north, but appear to have missed its most outlying structures by only half a kilometer. Simultaneously, a sustained eruption plume rapidly shot upwards at a rate which exceeded 100 miles per hour, or 161 kilometers per hour, soon reaching an altitude of 16,764 meters. This eruption was sustained and would continue without stopping for the next 80 minutes, during which the umbrella cloud expanded to 70 kilometers, or 43.5 miles wide. Heavy ashfall continued throughout the eruption, raining down and quickly accumulating to be 2.5 centimeters or an inch thick within a 6 kilometer radius of the eruption site. Several hours later, ash later rained down to form a dusting on the city of End, a whopping 80 miles or 128.8 kilometers to the west. And this is a city which is itself worrying about new volcanic unrest from a separate volcano to the south, but more on this later. By the time the continuous phase of the eruption ended at noon local time, I estimate that around 38 million cubic meters of rock had been emplaced. Thankfully, no far-flung lava bombs were thrown this time, with most of the tephra being deposited via more extensive pyroclastic flows. But what was the exact eruption type which occurred? In my opinion, Lewotobi's November 7th eruption perfectly met the criteria for a sub-plinian eruption, especially with its towering umbrella cloud. It involved a more than 1 hour-long sustained eruption plume. This plume reached a maximum altitude of 16.8 kilometers, and sufficient tephra was ejected to define the eruption on the volcanic explosivity index as a 3. As a result of this subplinian eruption, the summit crater of the Laki-laki cone has greatly changed. For one, it appears that its western crater rim, which had marked the Laki-laki cone's highest point, is just gone. This is one reason why the exclusion zone was expanded further to the west and west-southwest. This has made Laki-laki's highest point become 20 meters or 66 feet shorter. But it is not just this sector of the crater rim which has vastly changed, although more analysis is needed. Thankfully, this time it appears that no injuries and no deaths occurred. I plan to make another video on Lewotobi as its situation develops, with the next one to include an in-depth analysis of Lewotobi's eruption chronology so far.